everyone, it's Jen, and I'm here today with a flip through of one of the new coloring books that Colorit just came out with. So they contacted me and asked me if they could send me a copy of their new Mandalas 4 volume, and I said, sure, I don't have any of their Mandalas. And this was nice because they actually said I could do just a color and chat with it. I could just show the pictures. I could just color a picture and talk about it. I didn't have to have anything specific up for them. And I really appreciate that because, you know, we're all busy. We all have different things to do. So I definitely was on board, and they sent it to me, and I actually did color a picture in it, which you'll see when we get there. So this is a new thing that Colorit's been putting in their books recently. It kind of gives you an idea of different color palettes that you could use in the books. And I definitely was looking at these. I like this one a lot, and I think I will definitely try that out in a different picture. I didn't do it in this picture because I had a plan. Also, this is a blotter page. So these pages are all on white single side cardstock type paper, and they give you the blotter page so that you can take it out and put it in between if you want to use markers. Even though these are cardstock, you should always use a blotter page in between, especially if you use markers. You don't necessarily need it if you use pencils unless you push real hard. But if you use markers, like alcohol markers, you're definitely gonna wanna do that. So they have even a scan code that all you have to do is take your phone, your smartphone, and take a picture of this. And then it will bring you to their Colorit Book Club Mandalas 2 Color Volume 4. So that's very exciting. So here's your belong to page. Now I'm not gonna linger too long on these. I think I'm actually gonna zoom you in a little bit so that you can get a better idea. And I probably will just go ahead and bring these up closer to you so that you can see them better. Cause I think that since they're so intricate, it might be a little better to be able to show you up close. So like I said, I'm not gonna linger too long in the pages because it's a little bit different than when you're looking at pages of characters and things like that. Mandalas are just kind of lines and patterns and things like that. But these are really beautiful. And I had a hard time choosing which one I wanted to do. I really did like this one a lot, but I also really wanted to get a page colored in it before I actually show it to you. So I tried to choose something that wouldn't take up too much of my time. And I think I did a good job with what I picked, and we'll talk about it when we get there. This one, for some reason, I don't know, it reminds me of summer. It reminds me of The Little Mermaid. I'm not sure what it is about it, but something definitely reminds me of that. So I would definitely go with like some mermaid colors for this one. Now, you guys know me if you've been watching me for a while. I'm not too much of a mandala person. I don't have very many of the books. In fact, the ones like this with just the regular mandalas, I don't really, maybe I might have one or two. But I choose to actually just get like mandalas with like characters or the Christmas ones or Halloween ones. Those ones are ones that I will always go for because you guys know I'm a sucker for any kind of Christmas or definitely Halloween book. But this one I was just really interested in. I really like working with Colorit. They have really nice quality books that give you 50 pages to color on really nice paper that you could use any medium that you like on it. And they're nice because they're also spiral bound books. So no matter what hand you are dominant in, you won't have a problem coloring it. This was cool because as I was working with it, I was able to just turn the book around and color in different ways. So that's not something that we always do with our books. Especially when, you know, you're coloring a sky, it's kind of awkward to like color it upside down or whatever, but with these you can do that. So I always like to work with Colorit. Like I said, they're a quality company. They really care about their audience and their customers. They do listen to feedback, and they do try to provide us with a lot of really beautiful books on nice quality paper. So I'm not a Colorit affiliate. They just actually sent this to me for a review or for me to enjoy and show to you and let you know if I did enjoy it. So I'm going to leave the link, if I can find it, on Amazon to this below. Also, not an Amazon affiliate, so there's nothing there. And I will leave the Colorit link for it, if I can find it, as well. I don't know the status of it. Sometimes when I show these things, they're sold out by the time I show them. Or sometimes they're just not available, whatever the case is. So I will look for the links and put them in below. And as long as I can find them, they will be there for you. So as you can see, these are really nice. They are not too, I mean, from here on the camera, I could see it looks like it might be very detailed. But when I bring it up close to you, you can see it's really not. There's a really nice opportunity with open spaces on this, so that you could leave open white space if you wanted to. You know, when you're coloring mandala, it almost feels like you have to color every single thing in, but you really don't. You can do patterns in it. You could do any colors you want in it. You could do a half one way and half another way. I mean, there's so many opportunities for different things with mandalas. So it's really up to your imagination. You know, as much as you could imagine, you can do. This type of page where it's like totally full would be something that I would do when I'm like watching a movie, or I'm just trying to keep my hands busy during a conference call or something like that. Something that I'm not going to concentrate on colors or try to make a pattern. I'm just trying to keep my hands busy, my mind kind of focused on whatever I'm doing and not focusing on the coloring or anything like that. And just putting color down on the paper. Typically when I'm doing that, I use gel pens. Sometimes maybe markers, but most part gel pens, glitter gel pens are usually what I like to use. And that's just what I do. Everybody has different tastes and different feelings on how they like to do these kinds of things, if they like to do these kinds of things. It's not for everybody. But I have to tell you, the picture that I worked on, I found it so enjoyable. Now, I did have to concentrate on it a little bit. I'm sorry if you hear Snow White whining in the background. Emilio's outside. She wants to go outside too. So what was I saying? I did have to concentrate on my picture a little bit because I had a focus in mind of what I wanted to do and what I wanted to show you as far as the picture and the paper goes. So it wasn't total relaxing time, but I will tell you that I did really enjoy the coloring that I did on the page, and I was actually really happy with the outcome. I'm not too good with these kinds of things, with making it into some sort of color pattern and making it beautiful. It never works out well for me. I just don't make it as beautiful as some of the other ones that I see out there. Not to say it's not enjoyable for me, because it is, but just mine, I always feel like they look like a bunch of colors. And there are some people that can just really focus and make them super beautiful. So when I actually got done with mine, I was really surprised by how much I actually liked it. And I'd leave it out so it would dry. I kept looking at it and looking at it. I was like, wow, I actually really like this. Good job, Jen. So this is obviously the one that I did. Like I said, I was looking for something that wouldn't take up too much of my time, so I'd be able to show you the book relatively soon after I received it. So I finished this on May 3rd, and it took me about 2 days to color it. So what I wanted to show you in this, and I know the lighting's not awesome, but we're going to do the best that we can with it. I wanted to show you that I used lots of different mediums on this. So, for instance, there is glitter gel pen around the outside, and on the inside, two different kinds of glitter gel pen. So these are the Kaiser ones, and these are, I can't think of what those ones are, but they're a different kind. And then in here in the orange is ink tents, so I have that in there. Out here and all on this like little sun thing or whatever that is actually Tao Tree markers. In here is Tao Tree markers. In here are the Inconic fine liners from Arteza. This is Tao Tree. All of the marker part is Tao Tree. And what else do I have in here? The purple. So the purple on the outside of these things is all Prismacolor pencils. So, and also on the green and the blue are those glitter highlighters that I showed you recently, those zebra ones that I showed in one of my hauls. So I just really wanted to show you that these pages take anything. And look how bright and beautiful the colors are. I mean, this stuff obviously did go through, but I used something on the background. But that's just the, what you see here is just the alcohol markers. It's not like the pencils don't show through, the fine liners don't seem to show through. It's just the alcohol markers, and even it's not that deep. Now, like I said, they are single-sided, so it doesn't matter, and you do have to keep something in between your pages just to make sure they don't run through. But it just shows you the quality of the paper and how really nice it is. It's nice, smooth paper. It's not shiny at all, and it's very matte, so it's really nice to color on. You'll have a really nice coloring experience in the Colorit books, not just this one, but all of them. So if you have this book, or if you're into mandalas, I think you would really love this book if you haven't already purchased it. But if you're into these kind of things, let me know in the comments below, because I mean there's a few people that I watch on YouTube that do them, like Lisa's Coloring Corner, and I think Nikki and Niagara. Yeah, I think they both do these like on a regular basis, but not many people do. So I do see a lot of people on Instagram posting their pictures, and gosh, people do such amazing things with these, like I was talking about before. They're just stunning, and I don't know how they come up with it, but maybe I'm just not that creative to come up with the idea. But I just, some of these just stun me, and I love when people go in with like two colors, one color, like maybe all different kind of pinks, all different kind of reds or blues. Yeah, they're beautiful. This one reminds me of those spiral things. Do you remember what they were called? Like spiral glyphics or something like that, that we had as kids. Like you put a pen on the paper and it would make these kinds of designs. That's exactly what that reminds me of there. And something like this is really good for like testing out your mediums, or even you want to do one every day as a goal to just get the whole page done. That's nice too. I really like this one. This one intrigues me. I don't know what I would do with this one because of so many of the spaces to color, and so many like blocks in it. But I think if I got like a pattern going, I think it could be really, really nice. So as you can see, if this is your kind of thing and you like doing these kinds of things, this would be a great book to take with you on a trip, or if you're gonna go stay at someone's house, if you're going on maybe a long bus ride, plane ride, train ride, whatever. This is great. I mean, also because you could use any medium on it. If you only wanted to do watercolors, only wanted to do markers, only wanted to do gel pens, fine liners, anything. It just, everything works on it. So this is one of those versatile books that is, I mean, it's a little hefty, so there's a little weight to it, but if you're only bringing like this kind of book, it's no problem. Also, since they are perforated pages, if you wanted to take some out and just take them with you, you could absolutely do that as well. You could just put them in a folder and take some with you. Or another nice idea is, everybody loves homemade gifts. And since, you know, COVID is still going on, there are people like me who are still social distancing and staying away from others. You could absolutely color one of these, take it out, put it in a frame, and send it to a friend if you wanted to. Or just put it in an envelope and send it to a friend. Say, hey, I was thinking of you and I colored this picture for you. So there. So you can do all kinds of nice things with these. They're nice. It's a nice gesture to do something like that. I mean, I always loved when I had my P.O. box. You guys always would send me all kinds of pictures that you colored, and I had them hanging in my office for the longest time, and I just loved looking at them every day when I was working. It made me know that you guys were thinking of me. Somebody made me a glitter mandala bookmark, which I still have in my case of bookmarks. Yeah, I just, you know, it does, you might think it sounds silly, but it really means a lot to the person that you send it to, because they know that you put your hard work into creating something for them. So I hope that gives you some ideas of different things that you could do with these books. And I mean, a lot of us have like the Amazon type paper mandalas. And I will say one thing about those pages, not just the mandalas, but just those pages, they eat your markers. I mean, they're going to eat your markers and your pencils because you're using probably twice as much pencils to do layering, or if you're pushing down on them to get the color in there so you don't have white spaces. They eat the markers fast. It's not a joke, that's the truth. They just suck up the ink. So something like this, it doesn't. So this is really nice because it can actually save you money on your markers. You'll get probably twice as much, if not three times as much use with a book like this with your markers than you would with the Amazon book. So although these books usually run about $19.99, in the long run, if you don't have to replace your markers as often, it kind of is either a savings or it just like totally evens out. So, you know, there's pros and cons to everything, but I definitely think, and I've always said with Colorit books, I really think they're beautiful, they're high quality, they're definitely worth it. They store very nicely on your shelf. They're easy for anybody, left-handed, right-handed, to color. And I just really, I mean, I have a really nice appreciation for the company, for what they stand for how they care about their colorists, and for about the products that they put out for us. So I have completely talked your ear off, and I hope that you enjoyed seeing this really, really pretty book. I would love to know if you have this book, if you're going to pick it up, or if you're interested in it, anything, or if you just even have a comment on it. Clearly, I'm having problems turning pages today, so I apologize. But I think this is the last one. And like I said, I really think the book is beautiful. Loved working in it, really relaxing and nice. And of course, these are the nice hardcover books from Colorit. So I want to thank Colorit so much for sending this to me. I am definitely going to be enjoying some more coloring time in this, especially I think this is something I would like to bring to the beach because I don't get any like serious coloring time at the beach. It's more like you color two things and then you're up running around doing something with the child. So something like this, you can't get too distracted from. You just go to it, you do it and enjoy it and then stop. So I hope that you guys find something in it that you like. I hope you pick up a copy, and thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon.